All right, everybody worldwide, you're now tuned into DangerVision, and I'm your host, Tom Danger. Back this week with another review. And this week in the building, we have Tidal versus Google Play, if that makes sense. Let's talk about this for a minute. Is it going to be a classic, or are we going to pass it? Speaking specifically to Tidal. Truth be told, we're going to have to pass it. Now, what I did was, because there's two different pricing versions for Tidal, all right? I think there's a $10 plan, and then there's there's a $9.99 plan, and then the other plan is for $19.99 per month. And with $19.99, you're supposed to get access to HIFI audio material. It's been advertised as CD quality. So, you know me being skeptic, I basically, signed up for a trial account. And what I did was, I actually loaded both Tidal and Google Play side by side. And I did a little sound check with Meth and Red, the Rockwaller, because I dig that track. And right now, we're going to listen to a hi-fi version, just a couple of seconds of the Rockwaller.
Oh my God. Oh my God.
Checker, swinging sword lecture, closing down the sector, supreme neck protector, better want him kid, Mr. Messer, ballin' pop, pop the blow with lead from the pressure, too hot for TV, for sheezy, too many wanna be Harvey, easy, it's all in together, going all out together, it don't...
Alright, now we're gonna switch it to Google Play, same track, let me take this from the beginning, let it rock.
Oh my God!
Checker, swinging sword lecture, closing down the sector, supreme neck protector, better want him kid, Mr. Messer, ballin' pop, pop the blow his lid from the pressure, too hot for TV, for skeezy, too many wanna be Harvey, easy, it's so...
Okay, good enough for me. So, I'm asking myself the question, basically, the hi-fi version of Tidal will cost you about $235 a year, right? Versus Google Play, which I currently pay $7.99 a month, which will cost you about $95 a year. The Tidal does have an audio search feature. And I haven't tried this with Google Play. I know that Google does have the speech to text type of feature where you can just say the artist's name and it'll pull it up. But this one on Tidal has specifically sort of like SoundHound. And I tried humming different versions of songs, singing the words to songs, and that shit wouldn't work. So I'm like, it's a cool feature that's there, but it should be more intuitive. So what we did on the flip side is, I grabbed another phone, pulled up a song on YouTube, put the audio search to the phone, and then it found it 1, 2, 3. But you shouldn't have to work that hard, okay? Now, going back to the sound quality, if you listen closely in the audio clip between the two, is there a greater sound quality with Tidal? Absolutely, I will not dispute it. Is it something that's worth paying $19.95 a month for? Not at all, not at all. There's other places where you can listen to the same quality music. I don't even have to name them, but you know where you can go and check out the music. Tidal also has, if you go to an artist page, it's set up by, artist description and albums. Then it has a video tab, then it has a social tab. So, of course, I search Jay-Z. All his albums come up. All of his videos come up. When you click on the social tab, nothing comes up. It just hangs. So I search Beyonce. Same thing. All of the albums come up. A bunch of videos come up. And you search on the social page, and it just hangs. So I said, you know what? Let me take this a step further. For those of you who don't know, I'm also Tommy Danger, the Now Leader Man. I have several mixtapes out. So I said, let me see if any of my product is actually on Tidal. So I pull it up, and I have a couple of joints out there under the Now Leader Man. And it was cool. Nothing really in the artist description and nothing under videos, right? But however, when I go into Google Play and I put in my artist name, the Now Leader Man, the albums come up, and attached to it are some interviews that I've done, as well as some reviews that I've done. So again, intuitively between the two, I don't know what a disconnect is at, but if you're really looking at platforms and paying more, you should be getting more, not less. I don't know. Overall, I really don't dig it. Another point that I did. So in listening to the sound quality of my own material or independent artist material, there wasn't that much of a difference between Google Play and Tidal as it was with a major artist. I first noticed the sound quality difference on Tidal when I listened to Kendrick Lamar's album on Google Play, and then I was just messing around with Tidal and I put in Dr. Dre's album, I think it was The Chronic, and you could automatically hear the higher level of sound quality. But again, is it worth $19.99? I don't think so. But then again, what do I know? Subscribe to the page. Thanks for watching. With that being said, let's go into a video. Flat out.